By virtue of the authority vested in me, I constitute this a congregation of Rhodes University.
Dear Rhodes University graduate, graduation marks a significant milestone and a memorable experience in the academic pursuit of any university student. We deeply regret that due to the outbreak of the COVID-19 pandemic, which is wreaking havoc in our country and elsewhere in the world, we have not been able to hold our normal graduation ceremonies on our university campus this year. On that score, we salute and honor all our healthcare workers who are on the front lines of our nation's fight against this deadly virus. We commend them for their bravery, courage, and selfless service to our nation and humankind. On behalf of our Chancellor, our Council, and the entire Rhodes University community, I offer you our warmest and proud congratulations on your stellar achievements. We share with you and your loved ones in the excitement of having received the best education from one of the finest universities in the world. We extend special and heartfelt congratulations to those of you who are first in your family to earn a university degree. This is certainly a very proud and special moment for you and your family. Well done. We also convey our hearty congratulations to your parents and guardians and loved ones who have supported you, who have encouraged you, and stood by your side throughout your years of study at Rhodes University. Your accomplishments belong to you as much as they belong to them. Now that you have received quality education from a university where leaders learn, you have a responsibility to make a positive change in our society and the world. Wherever you find yourself, may you lead to serve and do so with honor, integrity, and humility. In a world characterized by insatiable greed, crass materialism, and conspicuous consumption, a world in which one's worth is judged by the amount of personal wealth amassed, may you heed Mahatma Gandhi's injunction that you live simply so others may simply live. In a world mired in despair, hopelessness and strife, may you be a source of hope, a source of comfort, and an inspiration for a better future to which we all aspire. May you live a life of meaning and a life of purpose, a life that enhances the lives of others, always ready to be God's answer to someone's prayer. In all that you do, may you be guided by values of social justice, human dignity, kindness, empathy, integrity, honesty, and human solidarity, always endeavoring to brighten the corner where you are. May your light dispel the darkness of selfishness, greed, bigotry, hatred, and prejudice. As Gemini Khan suggests, may your light shine as an inspiration to humanity, and may you be the reason someone believes in the goodness of people. You have so much to offer humanity. Go out there and change our society and the world for the better. Hearty congratulations, Mazel Tov, and Godspeed.
I confer degrees on and award diplomas and certificates to all those candidates named in the program who are in absentia.
Mr. Chancellor, I present to you Miss Mary Maria Burton, Professor Patricia Whitelock, Father Michael Lepsley, and Miss Madosini Mankena for the conferral of their honorary degrees.
I confer the degree of Doctor of Laws honoris causa on Miss Mary Maria Burton, Professor Patricia Whitelock, and Father Michael Lapsley, and the degree of Doctor of Music honoris causa on Miss Madosini Mangena, who are all in absentia.
Mr. Chancellor, I have the honor of presenting to you candidates for the award of the Vice Chancellor's Distinguished Medal. The inaugural recipient of the Achievement Award, Professor Justin Jonas. The Teaching Award, Ms. Tina Macabella. The Senior Teaching Award, Mr. Chris Upfold. The Book Award, Professor Samantha Naidu. The Research Award, Dr. Gladman Tundlana. The Senior Research Award, Professor Makaiko Chitambo. And the Community Engagement Award, Dr. John O'Davey, Mr. Andrew Todd, and Mr. Ben Ryan.
It is my pleasure to present the Vice Chancellor's Awards to these members of the academic staff who are in absentia. I congratulate all those graduates who have now just received their degrees, and I hope that they will be successful in their future endeavors. I also congratulate the candidates who received diplomas and certificates, as well as the members of the academic staff who received the Vice Chancellor's Award. Thank you.
Dear graduates, I know how disappointed you are that your graduation was postponed indefinitely due to the outbreak of COVID-19. As the new DVC Academic and Student Affairs, I have been equally disappointed, for this would have been my first graduation to celebrate with you. I fully understand how you feel, and I know how important a normal graduation ceremony would have been to you, especially those of you who are first generation graduates from your families. This is not how you envisioned your graduation. I'm sure you had grand plans to cross the stage in the presence of your families, friends, and professors. You had big plans to celebrate with them. This virtual graduation can never replace that moment. What makes it special is that it symbolizes the fruit of your toil. You have earned it. The risk of celebrating your graduation in the normal way amidst the pandemic was way too high. It is a risk we could not afford to take. Still, we celebrate you. We acknowledge your effort, your achievement, and success in the best possible way, virtually. Remember that the value of your accomplishment stays the same, and that we still look forward to a time of celebrating with you. Congratulations to you and your families. You have made us all very proud.
Dear graduates, on behalf of the SRC and the student body of Rhodes University, I would like to congratulate you on your achievement. Today, we are celebrating your efforts and success. To borrow from the late great Robert Mangalisa Sobukwe, for us, education means service to Africa. May you go on to serve Africa and the world at large with the greatest integrity, commitment, and honor.
Hello, my name's Tom Martin. I'm the Dean of Humanities at Rhodes, and I just want to take this opportunity to congratulate all of you who have graduated with degrees in my faculty this year, from bachelor degrees right through to honours, postgrad diplomas, masters and PhDs. I wish that we could be doing this face-to-face and hope that we will be able to meet face-to-face sometime soon. In the meantime, congratulations and best wishes to you and to your families.
Thank you. our graduates, I just wish you the best of success and go out and make a change in the world. To those of you who've qualified as teachers, to the masters and PhD students who have generated new knowledge. We're in a very uncertain time, but I just want to say well done to all of you and go out and make the most of it.
Pharmacy is proud of you for achieving your BFarm, MFarm, MSc-Farm, PharmD, and or PhD degree. What you need to learn is the following. Money can be stolen. Strength may fail you. But what you have learned is yours forever. Of course, we're disappointed you won't get to watch you walk across the stage like we always dreamt. And on behalf of the pharmacy profession, we welcome you. Believe in yourself and what you're going to offer to the world. You've made it. Well done for graduating.
Graduation is a time of great happiness and celebration, as degrees are conferred and diplomas are awarded to students who've completed their qualifications. The worldwide COVID-19 pandemic precludes us from doing this together, face to face. But what it has done is give me the opportunity to congratulate you personally, one-on-one. I'm sure you recall your first day at Rhodes, the people you met who are now your best friends, your first lecture, and your first encounter with your lecturer, and maybe even your dean. Now, a handful of years later, having successfully navigated all the requirements for the award of the qualification, you stand as a graduate of the faculty and the university. I want you to know that I'm enormously proud of your achievement. Carry your parchment with even greater pride. You deserve it. Many, many congratulations to you and to those who have supported you throughout your studies. Now, go celebrate with your family and friends.
Mama Land. Rhodes University graduates of 2020, congratulations. A special word of congratulations to the 89 LLB students who graduated in April. You have earned your old gold hood. Well done. A special word of congratulations must also go to Dr. Lloyd Chigoe, PhD graduate of the faculty. You will do us proud, Lloyd. I know that.
Graduation time is the favorite time of the year for a dean because it gives us opportunity to celebrate with you. And we can celebrate with your family, we can celebrate with your friends. All that hard work has paid off. You're now a graduate of Rhodes, be it your first degree or be it your fourth degree. I think it's wonderful. I think it's awesome. You guys have done so well. And unfortunately, we can't get together to celebrate in person, but we'll celebrate virtually.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I dissolve this congregation of Rhodes University.